Hi guys, my name is Jim Kerr. This is Cherisse Osei, as you all know. Welcome back to the Simple Minds Summer Tour Diaries. So today we're going to follow you around a little bit. So let's begin.
Okay, that sounds good. Let's go.
How would you start your day? How would the day begin?
I would start my day by getting up probably quite early and I head to the gym. I normally start with a run, so I run for about 15 minutes and I'll do some core exercises. I'll do some shoulder strengthening exercises, some weights. And to end my session, I'll go swimming about 15, 20 minutes and then I'll also go in the sauna and steam room. You know, just really good for the muscles.
My boyfriend has an allotment. So I get to eat a lot of organic and fresh produce. And in my time between the tours, I like to come here and pick the ingredients. I find it quite therapeutic. It tastes amazing, really sweet. Yeah.
I started playing the drums when I was 11 at school. Like, I heard there was a drum club starting at my school every week on Thursday at lunchtime. I just went, oh, I'm gonna go to that, just see what it's like. Like, I remember for the first time seeing the drums and thinking, wow, they just look really, I'll just draw to them.
Then I actually had to leave school at 17, which is when I got signed to Polydor Records, and that was the start of my drumming career, and that was with a band called The Faders. Straight after The Faders, I started playing with a new artist at the time called Mika, and we ended up touring the world for 7.5 years. So next, I started playing with Brian Ferry, which was absolutely unbelievable. But at the same time, I was playing with Paloma Faith. I'd never forget playing in the Bird's Nest Stadium in Beijing. That was for the Paralympic closing ceremony. That was in 2008.
My dad, as I said, was into soul and jazz and funk, Billie Holiday. My dad would say, listen to this. You know, this is a great singer. Can you hear? He would say, can you hear that? So my mum was more into things like Van Morrison, Led Zeppelin, The Beatles, Fleetwood Mac,
Neil Young,
so I had all of that influence.
Well, I have a wide range of drumming influences. You know, going from Sheila E. to John Bonham. Two of my favourite drummers would be James Gadson, who played with Bill Withers, and Levon Helm from the band.
But we have to talk about the records that made you go, I want to do
it. It's a Latin jazz band called Soboy, and there's an intro, a drum intro to one of their songs called 24 for Betty Page. It's this drum intro on the bell of the ride, and it's really fast. It's like this, like almost drum and bass sort of drumming, but on a jazz track. So drum and bass drumming, this mad feel, and this, you know, this really kind of Latin style of drumming mixed with, there's just this fusion of drumming that I've never heard before, and it blew my mind,
outside of recording, touring, all that. Do you have a place where you practice?
I have like a studio in my back garden. It's one big room. I've got my drum kit in there and I've also got a recording set up in there so I can record myself, which has been a very useful tool for me. I try and practice as much as possible. I will be doing 8 hours a day.
I'm very passionate about the gear that I play because that gear is the gear that you're gonna, you know, that is your sound. My favourite part of the drum kit is probably the snare drum. And I actually collect vintage snare drums.
I do actually have a drum teacher and I have drum lessons. I've had lessons with Mike since I was 15 and I think it's really important as a musician to keep developing your skills and keep learning.
It's absolutely fascinating to hear that. In all my life of working with people, I'm having trouble recalling any of them who still have a teacher. That's what really makes you different from me, that it's not even enough to say pro. You're more than that. You're absolutely dedicated. Who do you teach? How do you teach? Why is it important to teach?
It kind of happens organically that people were just coming to me. Through doing that, I just really enjoyed it. Like, I love passing on the knowledge that I've learned over the years.
So as well as teaching, I also do masterclasses, and I've actually been lucky enough to do them internationally. My first one that I did was at a festival called Tam Tam Festival, which was in Seville, which was a really great experience doing my first clinic, you know, in Spain.
It looks like you're getting involved in making films, this being one of them. And the films, is that something you're looking to more of in future?
Yes, it is. I've actually got a few projects that I'm working on at the moment.
How do you chill out from it all?
I usually like to take the evening off. I'll either do some yoga, I really enjoy stretching to kind of relax me. I also meditate. And I remember sitting down for the first time behind the drum kit, playing a very basic drum beat. And I vividly remember that first time, and I just felt at home. I knew in that moment that I wanted to do this for the rest of my life. I'm going to be a drummer. That's it. I found my calling.